Hello, hello, baby, you called, I can't hear a thing. I have got no service in the club, you say. What did you say? Oh, you're breaking up on me. Sorry, I cannot hear you, I'm kind of busy.
Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Tea the Java TV, bringing you the Tea the Java in under 5. Today, we're going to start off with talking about someone who everyone knows because of her sex tape that she had with our fair Ray J. Miss Kim Kardashian, if you did not know, she was recently engaged or talking to. I know they was in a relationship. She was in a relationship with Reggie Bush. On March the 9th, Reggie sent her a text message on her phone stating that he feels that they need to separate, that it's not him, it's not her, it's him, and he just needs to get himself together at this present time of his life. Kim Kardashian, I have one notion of advice for you. Here in the African-American community, I've heard both through my homosexuals and heterosexual friends that there is a huge shortage on good black men. Stop chasing after them. You might go better off with another race, I would think, but you might want to stop. In recent news, also, Reggie Bush has been seen with her brother and at some of the nightclub that they were at on Friday, and he was texting the whole night. Even though there was like all kind of girls just like surrounding him, he was just sitting there texting. I'm thinking he's texting Kim Kardashian, but so much for their relationship. But why are people so problematic in relationships? It's two people getting together, learning each other, and deciding on if we're going to stay together or not. Some people don't like dating. Back in the day, a date was basically a person came up to you and say, "Hi, how are you doing? My name is Wyatt. I would like to get to know you. What is your name? What are your interests?" Okay, well, it seems that we're compatible. We're hitting it off. Okay, how about we go hang out? Okay, well, on Monday. All right, cool. Pick you up Monday. Oh, had a great evening. Okay, how about we hang out again? Oh, Wednesday, are you available? Okay, Wednesday. We hang out Wednesday. Nowadays, it's like, hey, well, not even, hey, it's, what's up, shouting? You sure is looking good over here. What's your number? All right, I'll holler at you. Come Monday. What's up? I'm going to come scoop you up. Now we're together. We're in a relationship. What kind of shit? I don't even know you. Get the hell away from me. For some unknown reason, people don't like dating. Granted, a dating process is very, very lengthy. If you are a person who is dating, you're going to probably date several different people at one time in this whole process to figure out who's going to be your soulmate. Your soulmate is not going to just come up at you at like an hour after getting to know a person. I've come to find out in my dating process that after 3 months, you find out a whole nother person. You find out who this person really and truly is. Then when you move in, that's a whole nother person. So why, after meeting a person a month or a week or so like that, you want to be in a relationship with them? Slow down. Pump your brakes. You got the rest of your life to live. Try to focus on you. It's funny how I always hear people who like to smile, "I need a man. I need a woman." Okay, well, what type of woman, what kind of guy are you looking for? Oh, just anyone. Well, be careful with what you ask for, because anyone can be Joe Bob, who is homeless on the side of the street and who's cracked out every day. That's anyone. My mother always told me, my grandmother, I've always heard that whatever you want, pray for it. Pray for exactly what you want, and in due time it will come. So if you need a man, pray for the exact right man that you want and leave it alone. Know that God is going to send it to you. No matter who he is going to be, it's going to come to you because you prayed over it, you gave it to God. And you moved on. Live your life. Know who you are. If you don't know who you are, how are you going to expect somebody else to love you? That's one key thing, knowing who you are. If you know who you are, you know what type of person you're looking for and what type of person is going to mess with you in order to build a harmonious environment and a harmonious relationship that you guys will be together forever. I mean, no longer are we back in the day where you meet up with a person when you're 13 years old and y'all stay together until y'all die. Think about it. Until the next time on T2 Java. Ta-ta for now. Kisses.